Hello students, children, in this session we are going to learn about two more salts, that is plaster of Paris and bleaching powder. So let us start with bleaching powder. Common name of the salt is bleaching powder, which is also known as chlorinated lime. Another name of this is chlorinated lime. Its chemical name is calcium oxychloride, and its molecular formula is CaOCl2. Children, it is white solid. Physical properties: white solid, alkaline means basic in nature, much better, basic in nature. Okay, next property is highly oxidizing agent. Highly oxidizing agent due to the formation of chlorine gas. Okay, and one more property, that it smells like chlorine gas. It smells like chlorine gas. Bleaching powder, chlorinated lime. Okay, chemical name, chemical calcium oxychloride. Formula CaOCl2. White solid means crystalline solid, and it is basic in nature. Highly oxidizing agent. The reason is only that due to the formation of chlorine gas, as well as it smells like chlorine. Okay, now preparation. It is prepared in laboratory by the process of Hazen-Clever method. It is prepared in laboratory by the process of, by which process? Hazen-Clever method. Okay, in this method, when chlorine gas is passed through dry slaked lime, there is a formation of calcium oxychloride. So let us write the balanced equation for this one. When chlorine gas is passed, Cl2 gas, okay, through dry slaked lime, the formula of dry slaked lime is calcium hydroxide. It is dry slaked lime. There is a formation of calcium oxychloride, CaOCl2 plus water. Now children, this calcium oxychloride, when reacts with atmospheric carbon dioxide, when we keep it in open, then it reacts with atmospheric carbon dioxide, and there is a formation of calcium carbonate. CaOCl2 means calcium oxychloride, when reacts with carbon dioxide, it forms calcium carbonate, CaCO3 plus chlorine. Now due to the formation of this one, it works as a bleaching agent also, it works as an oxidizing agent also. Now some of the uses of calcium oxychloride. First use, that in bleaching purpose, to bleach fabrics in bleaching industry. Second is to sterilize water. Okay, as well as this salt is mainly used to make wool unshrinkable. Means when we apply calcium oxychloride in woolen cloths, they become unshrinkable. Means their size does not become shrink. Okay, so one more use of this bleaching powder is to make wools, means woolen cloths, unshrinkable. Okay children, so this is all about bleaching powder. Clear? Now what type of questions can be formed on this topic? That first is direct question, that explain the process of formation of कैल्शियम ऑक्सीक्लोराइड और ब्लीचिंग पाउडर और क्लोरिनेटेड लाइम और कैल्शियम हाइपोक्लोराइड ऑल्सो. सो दीज क्वेश्चन कैन बी फॉर्म, दैट इज द डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन. बट वन इनडायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन विच आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस हेयर, दैट इज वन गैस विच इज वन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ क्लोर आल्कली प्रोसेस. ओके, so I'm just writing this high order thinking question HOTS on this topic. A gas X, okay, which is produced in chlor alkali process. Okay, a gas X which is produced in chlor-alkali process when passed through slaked lime, dry slaked lime, okay, dry slaked lime, there is a formation of compound Y with water. Clear? Compound Y is used to sterilize water also. Write down the balanced chemical equation, identify X and identify Y. Okay children, with the chemical name of reactants as well as chemical name of product also. So what you will do to solve these types of question, first you need to read the question properly. Second point, you have to write down the important points while reading the question. For example, a gas X. What are the properties of X is given? That it is produced in chlor-alkali process. Now children, just recall chlor-alkali process. In that process, only two gases were produced. First is hydrogen and second one is chlorine. Now the second hint, when passed through dry slaked lime, it means we have not studied any reaction in which we have passed hydrogen gas in dry slaked lime. So the hint is clearly given to you in this question that we are talking about chlorine gas. So first is X is equal to, that is chlorine gas. You need to write answer in separate individual points. The reason is only that each and every point in chemistry have a different or have a weightage. Okay, so separate weightage is there. So X is chlorine gas passed through dry slaked lime. It means we need to write down the reaction, that is calcium hydroxide when Cl2 gas is passed. Clear children? That is aqueous solution. We need to write here calcium hydroxide, okay, chlorine. Okay children, there is a formation of compound Y. Now which compound is formed? That is calcium oxychloride. So you need to write its name also here, calcium oxychloride. Okay, with the that Y is used to sterilize water, that is H2O is released. Now children, this answer is not a complete answer because we have not identified Y. We have written the reaction. We have written what is X, but in this reaction we have not written Y as separate. So you need to write Y is equal to CaOCl2, right? Now this answer is completed. I can also give the hint of the weightage of separate subparts of this question. It contains weightage of 1 mark, it contains weightage of 1 mark, or its total reaction is of 1 mark. It might be possible, or it might be possible that the second condition is that it has a weightage of half mark, it has a weightage of half, and it has a weightage of one, and one mark for the naming also. Means names of chemical compounds. Right, children? So this question has approx a weightage of 3 marks. Total weightage of this question is of 3 marks. In these questions, you need to write the answer of each and every point. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Bleaching powder, that is calcium oxychloride, X is chlorine gas, and Y is bleaching powder. Now let us discuss this another salt, that is plaster of Paris. Common name, plaster of Paris, POP. Okay children, POP is the common name. It means plaster of Paris. Its chemical name, always we are following this order. First we will write a common name, then we have to write its chemical name, that is calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Okay children, now calcium sulfate, very common compound, and I hope all of you know the formula of calcium sulfate, that is CaSO4. Clear? Hemihydrate means we are talking about hydrated salt. We are talking about water of crystallization, in which a fixed number of water molecules are attached or are the internal part of the crystal. When these fixed number of water molecules works as a internal part of the salt, then these are called as hydrated salt. These are called as hydrated salts, and these water molecules are known as water of crystallization. Now what is the meaning of hemi? Hemi means half. Okay, so water of crystallization always be shown by using this dot. Hemi means half, hydrate means water, half H2O. Now you must have this question in your mind, that ma'am, how can we divide water molecule into two equal parts? We will discuss about it later. Okay, first let us understand that hemi means half and hydrate means water. Second is preparation method. It is white powdery substance. Okay, preparation, it is prepared by gypsum. Now what is gypsum? Gypsum, its chemical name is calcium sulfate dihydrate. Again, it is a hydrated salt. Calcium sulfate, its formula is CaSO4. Dihydrate means 2H2O. Okay children, its common name is gypsum. When we heat gypsum at 100 degrees Celsius, means in this reaction there is a very value or weightage of temperature, because when we increase the temperature we will get a new product. Okay, so we have to keep watch on the temperature during this reaction, and this reaction takes place at 373 Kelvin. 373 Kelvin means 100 degree Celsius temperature. Okay, so let us write the balanced chemical equation for the preparation of, that is plaster of Paris. CaSO4 dot 2H2O, when we heat this salt at 100 degree Celsius, or we can say 373 Kelvin temperature. If we talk about SI unit, then 373, otherwise you can also learn 100 degree Celsius also. Then these water molecules will be evaporated. Okay, it happens that when we heat hydrated salts, water molecules will be evaporated. So what happens? 1.5 water molecule will be evaporated, and what is left behind, that is calcium sulfate half H2O. Now children, your point will be clear here, that what happens, that it is not half water molecule. Actually the complete reaction takes place in this manner, that 2 Ca SO4.2H2O. Okay, 2CaSO4.4H2O. Okay, 2H2O only, right? When we heat this at 100 degrees Celsius, there is a formation of 2CaSO4.H2O plus 3H2O. Now, just watch it carefully that one water molecule is shared by two molecules of calcium sulfate. One water molecule is shared by two molecules of calcium sulfate. So, ek calcium sulfate ke paas mein kitna molecule hoga water ka? That is half H2O. This is the reason in simplest form we will write the reaction in this manner. Actually, there is no division, there is no decomposition of water molecule. Here only one water molecule is present, but this water molecule is shared by two molecules of calcium sulfate. So, ek ke paas aaya half, and this is the reason we have written this reaction in this form. Okay. Now, next is that uses of plaster of Paris. Plaster of Paris is used in making statue, in making false ceiling, and as well as in medical purpose, doctors are used to just get the support of the fractured bone also. Okay, so they are the various uses of plaster of Paris. Now, whether it is possible that we can make gypsum from plaster of Paris again, whether it is possible? Yes, children, it is possible. So, its uses in making toys, okay, then ceilings means rooftops, okay, statue to support fractured bone. These are some of the uses of plaster of Paris. Now let us discuss how we can prepare gypsum again with the plaster of Paris. Listen that one. That when calcium sulfate hemihydrate means plaster of Paris is kept in open, then it reacts with water molecules and there is a formation of calcium sulfate, that is calcium sulfate dihydrate means gypsum. First point is clear to you, all of you? Okay, when calcium sulfate reacts with water at 473 Kelvin temperature, it forms calcium sulfate dihydrate. Okay, second thing is, children, that what is the importance of temperature over here? Actually, what happens if temperature increased by 100 degrees Celsius, then this water molecule, it also get evaporated. Okay, then actually what compound is left behind? That is only calcium sulfate, and this calcium sulfate is anhydrous calcium sulfate. This is called as anhydrous calcium sulfate. Why it is called as anhydrous? The reason is only that water molecules are not present. So now here I just want to tell you that salts are of two types also. One is hydrated salt and second is anhydrous salt. Hydrated salts in which the water of crystallization, wo salts jin mein water of crystallization ke molecules present hote, these are called as hydrated salt. Anhydrous salts, salts jin mein water of crystallization ke molecules present nahi hote hain. This is also called as dead burnt plaster. Dead burnt plaster. Okay, children. So these are the two names of calcium sulfate. This is the reason that temperature plays a very, very important role in this reaction. So this is all about two salts, calcium sulfate, hemihydrate means plaster of Paris, and second one is bleaching powder. Okay, children. Now